Welcome to this session on Jenkins. Today in this session we are going to learn how to use CATLIGHT status notifier for Jenkins. Let's get started. And the very first thing we have to know is what is CATLIGHT. So let's go to this website catlight.io. I'm going to my browser and I'm typing here CATLIGHT, and the very first option that I get is catlight.io. Let us go here. And this is the website for CATLIGHT, and it says this is a status notifier for developers, and it is available for Windows and also available for Mac and Linux operating systems. Let's go down, and it says CATLIGHT will notify you when builds, bugs and tasks need your attention. So basically CATLIGHT will monitor all the jobs on your Jenkins, and whenever there is any status change or anything that needs your attention, it will pop up on your desktop and you will get notified of all the changes and all the things you need to know. So you can select the things to track and then you can see status in your tray. So there will be this icon in your tray on your desktop which will keep on changing the colors based on the changes in your jobs. So this is a very useful feature. When you are managing and having multiple jobs in Jenkins, it is very difficult to go every time on the server and go to the dashboard and check for the notifications and changes and updates on every job. So it will be very handy and useful. You will get all the notifications on your desktop. You can get notified about the changes. You can get information when a build starts, when a build stops, or there is any failure or any changes, and all these details. So CATLIGHT can work with Jenkins but also with all these other tools. And now let us go back and let us understand how exactly can we use CATLIGHT. So using CATLIGHT will be very straightforward and simple. Let's go to the downloads link, and here you can download for Mac, Windows or Linux. So I'm going to download it on a Mac, but whether you are using Windows or Linux, you can follow along and you can download it for your operating system. Let me download it for Mac. So the download is now completed and I have placed the downloaded zip file in this folder. I will just unzip this file. And then I will just double click and start CATLIGHT, and you can see this is starting CATLIGHT. So then you will get these options to configure your server. So we will go to Jenkins. And here we will give the URL for our Jenkins. And of course, before that, we have to make sure that our Jenkins is running. So I will start my Jenkins. And let me just check my Jenkins is up and running. And yes, and I will just copy the URL. And because I'm using Jenkins for on my local machine, so it has localhost. And I will just give this URL here. So whatever IP and port you are using for your Jenkins, you can give it here. And then in case you are using any credentials, you can give it here or use anonymous and say save. There are some connection tips as well, so you can read it and save it. And now see, it is giving me all the projects that I have on my Jenkins. So you can see all these projects are being displayed here. So you can select which all projects you want to monitor, or you can select all. So let me just select all and I will say save, and now it will start monitoring all my jobs. So you can see all my jobs are getting monitored, and also you can see it is getting the past status as well. This was 2 months ago, this was 8 months ago, and all these other things. And also you can see there is this icon. So this is the CATLIGHT icon, and in case you are on Windows, you will get the same icon in your tray in at the bottom. And here this icon will change its color based on your build status. So you can go here, and let me do one thing. Let me just go to some job and let me just run it, and then let us see if I get any notification on this job or not on my desktop. And you can see I'm getting these notifications on my desktop about all the changes on the recent projects. And if I go to my CATLIGHT dashboard, also you will get all this information here. So you can say, you can see here, test one, it ran a few seconds ago and it was okay. So everything you can monitor and you can check the status from here. Also, you can go to the CATLIGHT menu and you can go to edit and settings. And here you can select your build notifications you want for all builds, my builds and other things. You can select the dashboard, how should it be sorted out, and other settings as well. So according to your need, you can do all these settings. Let us look at some useful tips. So you can go to this link for CATLIGHT support. If you go to the website, you have this support link. You can go here. And here you can get a lot of information about the updates, the knowledge base, questions, and all the problems faced by different people, and you can get the solutions here. Also, you can go to the blog, which is blog.catlight.io. So again, the link is here from the main page itself. You can go to this blog. And here you will get a lot of information and articles about CATLIGHT. I hope this session was very useful for you. In case you have any questions or doubts, please do write them down in the comments section below and I will try to answer as soon as I can. Thanks for watching and keep learning.